Your headliner tonight comes to us from New York City, where he is a frequent headliner at Caroline's on Broadway. He has made several television appearances, and among them, Penn and Teller's Fool Us. We are so excited that he could be here in Chicago to perform for all of you. So please give a warm Chicago welcome to Mark Clearview.
So you're here at a magic show, you don't know where to go. You came here instead of hanging out with your friends. You're ready to watch some magic tricks. You're ready to get high, you're ready for There's no in the show, it just rhymed. But Mark is in it, he's gonna have a good time. He's going to show you so much stuff that is true. He's gonna do crazy shit, so buckle up, you're not ready for it. You've never seen something quite like this. It's comedy and magic, and that's it. Wow, he's really cool. He does so much stuff, he's not a fool. He's going to do things, he's gonna rhyme real good. Not right now, because I couldn't think of something. Get ready, get ready, get the ready. Sit the down and shut the hell up. He doesn't need you for this. He could do it without you. No, he couldn't. That's just a joke. He's nicer than me. I'm someone else. Get ready. Are you ready? Hope that you're ready. I'm ready. You're ready. He's not ready. That's why he's not on stage just yet. But don't you worry and don't you fret. Oh, that was good. And now he's going to come on stage. Now. That was early. Now. Now, shit.
Shut up.
Nothing in my hands. Nothing in my sleeves. And yet, magic. And as the coins continue to appear at my fingertips, you begin to ask yourself, is this reality that I'm living in? Or is it simply an illusion? And not only do they appear in order of denominational value, they now begin to appear in a very specific sequence of international currency, in alphabetical order according to the country of origin. And now, in the chronological order correlating to the year in which they were originally minted. Another coin. Another coin. Another coin. Another coin. Another! Now that the coins have all turned to gold and subsequently vanished in a flourish of flames, the audience is thinking, wow, how did he flip each coin 11.5 times through the air, landing edgewise on the head of a pin? He's so handsome and wonderful, he definitely should have fooled Penn and Teller. Now that you have a bowl that's filled to the brim with silver dollars,
I will not be doing any coin tricks.
Thank you.
That was stupid. But we are about to get stupider. How are we feeling tonight? Chicago Magic Lounge! Yeah! That's great, I'm feeling the exact same way. Now, a little bit more about me that frankly you didn't ask for. My name is Mark Clearview. I've been doing magic since I was 6 years old. Which is unusual because most six-year-olds, they want to be like firefighters and protect the public. And I was like, not for me, I'll be a magician and protect my virginity. Don't laugh too loud. That's a joke, I have a girlfriend, okay? Who's bringing the first date to this show? You're doing the same type of protection, bringing your first date to a magic show. Huh, sweetie, we're celebrating, so oh my God, what's happening? Okay. I've been in a 3-year relationship thanks to one rule, which is never go to bed angry. We've heard this, yes?
Yeah.
Yeah, I haven't slept for 3 years. She would be very mad at that if she were real. Okay. Sir, what's your name?
Bill.
Bill? Bill, have we ever met before?
No, we haven't.
Then how did you forget this at my house? Bill. Bill. Do I mean nothing to you? Okay. Bill, can I show you everything that I know about life in under 2 minutes? Can I do that?
Sure.
Thank you, Bill. Watch closely. Life is emptiness. Abracadabra! Sir, what is your name?
Sloan.
Sloan. Sloan, name any liquid in the world.
Water.
Milk, good. Sloan, I'm kidding, of course. We've never met before, right? Many times we've met. Long lost brother?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'll find him one day. Sloan. Sloan, name any liquid in the world, please. Scotch. We didn't arrange anything before the show. Seriously, we did not arrange anything.
No.
You just said scotch off the top of your head.
Yes.
Watch this. Shit. The oldie but a goodie. You know, if the milk, if there's cereal there, maybe the milk can be in the same box. Here we go. That's a little milk for the cereal. Thank you so much. Thank you! Thank you. And some for the stage. Sir, what is your name?
Matt.
Matt. Matt, have we ever met before?
No.
Then how did you forget this at my house? Matt, God damn it. All you men are the same. Excuse me. Okay. Matt, do you know the trick in magic where a magician would pull a coin out from behind your ear?
Sure.
Do you know this one, audience? Yes?
Yeah.
Yes. It's a bit hacky. I do something a little bit different, a little bit more impossible. This is a big jumbo coin. There's nothing behind the dime except... I'll give it a minute. Okay, for all of you purists, if you liked the ear from behind the dime, you will love the dime from behind the ear. How did he... Oh, sir.
take a seat. It's time to go.
What is your name? It doesn't matter. Look at that. I can do whatever I want. It's crazy. You can't vape. I can. It's part of the show. Whatever I want to do. Okay. Did we do the dime thing? We did that. Yeah. Okay. Let's do some mind reading. What is your name?
Jessica.
Jessica, have we ever met before? We didn't arrange anything before the show. Jessica, what do you do for a living?
I'm a memory care director.
You are, sorry?
A memory care director.
A memory care director? This is perfect. I'm going to try to read your mind. Is that okay?
Dangerous.
You're dangerous. Okay, good. Here I have a whiteboard. There's nothing on it yet. In a second, Jessica, yes? In a second, Jessica, you will think of a word. Do not say the word out loud. This is very important. Sometimes I tell people, think of a word, and they go, eggplant. And I like to say to people, like, if you think of a word and I say that word to you, that's mind reading. But if you say a word to me and I say it back to you, that's a conversation. And not a very good one. Okay. Jessica, please start thinking of your word in your mind now. Do you have a word in your mind? You do. I'm going to try to read Jessica's mind, a miracle among miracles. Here we go. Send me the word now. TJ, can I get some mind reading music? Here we go. Jessica, out of curiosity, is the first letter of your word in your mind an F? It is? Apparently not very impressive. That was a 1 in 26 shot, so let's keep going for the rest of the word. Here we go. P is not in your word. I wasn't finished my sentence. P is not in your word. Wow, he's doing them both. No P. Is there a G? No G. L? Yeah, yeah, there is an L, okay. And Q? No Q. T? No T, okay. I lost. Yeah, all that for that. I heard you say, yes. This is the theme of the show. I know what went wrong, though. Jessica, I can't read your mind without your permission. That's a bit invasive. So I do have permission from you in the form of a waiver. All you have to do is sign it, okay? And I know people get a bit squirrely around waivers, so I'll just tell you what it says very quickly. All this says is that if you work for the government and you have secrets up there, then I'm not going to tell anybody, okay? Or if you went to the University of Chicago and you have nothing up there, then I won't tell... Before anyone gets upset, I'm allowed to do that joke. I went to the University of Chicago. Thank you very much. Bachelor of Arts. Thank you. Woo woo. That's the joke. I would never go there. Okay. So this is... You can sign that. Thank you. This goes over here. I'm joking. This goes over here. Now I have your permission to read your mind. Okay? I'm going to read Jessica's mind for real now. A word is much too difficult. We're going to try a card. One card, a 1 in 52 shot. This is happening. What's your name?
Sierra.
Sierra, have you ever seen this before?
No.
You're about to. Jessica, can you think of any card in the deck? Any card in the deck? And send it to me. And hopefully we are thinking of the same card, because I'm locked in. I can't change my mind. Now, you can't see this, right? Okay. Jessica, first time ever, big, loud voice. What card are you thinking of?
10 of hearts.
I lost again, okay? So that, that's another... Now you like it. Okay, that's good. This is another mezzanine hangman. Okay, okay. Come earlier next time. Okay, so this goes here. We're going to do a card trick. Jessica, I'll come back to you, okay? I trust you. I need somebody in the middle section of the house. Somebody in the middle section of the house to get the house lights up a little bit. I see your hand right here. What's your name?
Me, Mary.
Me, Mary? Beautiful name. Dutch. Okay. Just Mary. Mary. Mary, have we ever met before? What do you do for a living? Director of marketing for what company?
Yeah, a company that sells like plates to restaurants.
They sell plates to restaurants?
Yeah.
Mary, you don't have to make up a job. It's okay. If you don't have That's what you do? I shouldn't be making fun of you. I'm a magician. This is literally my job. Stupidest thing in the world. That's a real job. Okay, I trust you. Mary, I have a deck of cards in here. You can't verify back there that it's a normal deck, so people in the front row are going to do it for me. Everybody thinks that, like, this is a deck of all the four hearts or something. They're all different, I promise. Would you please verify all different cards? Yes? They're not all the same? Yeah, could you also verify all different? Not all the same? Yes? All different? Yes, yes, all different. What is your name?
Kirsten.
Kirsten, regular deck, yes?
Yes.
Good. Now we know we can't trust Kirsten because that's a notebook. They're all attached together, Kirsten. Kirsten, second try. I have another deck of cards inside here. These are a regular deck of bicycle playing cards. You've seen these, yes? Okay. Kirsten? I'll show you. These ones are not attached, and they are all different, yes? Yeah. Also attached, Kirsten. Come on! Get with the program. It's a crazy show. Everything is crazy. This is the rest of the show. Buckle up, okay? Kirsten, these cards, and I know you, I wouldn't want to look at me either. These cards are normal and not attached. You can't trust I know, we can't trust ourselves. It's true. I will prove it. I'm going to shuffle this deck, make sure they're not attached together. And to make Mary, I just want you to start thinking of a card, okay? But don't say it out loud. I'm going to give these deck shuffles, okay? It's French. I'm gonna give these decks a shuffles. And I'm actually from Canada originally. I don't know if you can tell, sorry. I'm going to give them what we call in Canada a prime minister shuffle, which looks like this. Okay, thank you, I'll do it again. Thank you. And it's called a prime minister shuffle because it looks good, but it doesn't do anything. It's Trudeau. Okay. Got it? There's multiple jokes in this show. No magic. Mary, I need you to start to think of a card. Do you have the card in your mind? Okay, Mary, not the Ace of Spades. Way too obvious. A lot of people will say the Ace of Spades. I need you to go with something a little bit difficult. And look at me, and this deck will read your thoughts. Folks, the jokes are out of the way. It is time to get to the bona fide miracles. Mary. Look at me and send me your card. The deck will do all the work. If you watch closely, you can actually see it happening. Do you want me to? Do I want you to say it?
Yeah.
Not yet. It wouldn't be very impressive. Okay. Here we go. Watch close. One card has risen out of the deck on its own volition. Mary, for the first time ever, what is the card that you are thinking of? The Four of Diamonds. Did you say don't try to put it back in there? That's the joke. Okay, you know what? We have a problem now, because if I just look through all the cards, that's a little too obvious. I know what the Four Diamonds looks like. So, I will shuffle them and I'll make my job a little bit harder. Pardon?
Nothing.
What did you just say?
Nothing.
What did you say?
It's on the bottom.
It's on the bottom?
Four.
Close. Tomorrow we'll do Shapes and Colors. Okay. Please have me back. Okay, Mary. Okay, great. So I'm going to do this a little bit differently because I know what that looks like. I'm going to do it without looking at the card, so I can't rely on my eyes to try to find that card, okay? And I'll make it a little bit more impossible. I'm going to try to do it without my hands, okay? So no hand usage here. I'm going to use something different than my hands, a little bit more impossible than that. I'm going to use my mouth to try to find your card, okay? And then remember, you could have said any card you wanted. You stuck with that one. I'm going to sanitize my mouth first. Oh! Ooh, that was hell. Pure hell. Comedy doesn't stop. All right. But the magic should start. So Mary, that is your real name. I need you. It really is, and you really sell plates. Okay. No, you don't even sell, you just market them. That's even better. Okay. Mary, I'm going to find your card with my mouth. Everyone, it's ready to go. All right, here we go. I'm going to shove this deck into the back of my throat. And deck, with an E. Yeah. I know what you're thinking. And try to find your card. Watch closely. Nothing in there. Deck goes in.
I'm going to put it in my mouth. For my booth, for my mouth, for my pardon? No. The deck is in my mouth.
The deck is in my mouth.
What? And nothing in my hands.
Nothing in my hands.
What?
Here we go. I'm gonna find the card and go, ta-da!
And then Susan's gonna be like, oh my god, how did you do that?
Then she's gonna be like, oh my god, how did you do that?
And Susan's gonna be like, what the fuck?
And he's gonna be like, huh?
Okay. No, it's all hot inside my mouth right now. I'm gonna find it. If I do find it, this is sad. I'll be like, oh, best everything in my life. Okay, wow, take my money. Take my money, make a man, honestly, okay? I'll be like, with all parties, we'll be like, woo, yeah! Mary. You have something else? You said the five diamonds? You said five diamonds. Okay, here we go. Okay. That's not a card. It's a five diamonds? Four, right? It's okay, Mary. Mary, go to sleep. What is it? Four or five? Four? It's just four, right? Okay. Alright, shit.
Mary, the four of diamonds, the card you named, folded up in my mouth with my tongue, and that is the four of diamonds! Thank you so much, thank you! And Mary, because you were such a good volunteer, Mary, you get a souvenir of the show to go home with. Isn't that a lovely souvenir? For me. Yeah, it's pot. Yes, thank you. If anybody needs anything explained, right over here. Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, that is the end of my show. I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you so much for being a part of it. I appreciate it. Thank you so much. Thank you. But before I get out of here, on a personal note, I really would just love to thank all of you sincerely. I know I've been a bit combative with you, and I appreciate it. It's all in good fun. I appreciate everyone being a good sport. I love you so much. I cannot do this without you. It's very awkward for me to stand on the stage in an empty room and do it alone. So, I couldn't do it, you know, for 2 years because of all the stuff that was happening. We couldn't gather and do this, and I don't want us ever to take that for granted again. Truly. As cheesy as it is, I get more magic from you than you get from me. This is what I love to do more than anything in the world. Thank you for continuing to make it possible. Big round of applause for you. Thank you. And because of that fact, to prove it, I would like to do a genuine miracle for you that I've been, you know, teasing throughout the whole show. And pardon? Drinks for everybody on me? A miracle, not an impossibility. So I'm going to do a magic trick. I'll just stick with the magic, okay? I want you, when you leave here and people say, you know, how is Mark Clearview? You'll say the usual stuff, right? Handsome, humble, of course. But I want you to say we saw something that was truly impossible. And so, Jessica, you're thinking of a word still, yes?
I mean, it's still
there. It's still in there. Did you read the fine print on the waiver at all? No. So all it says is that you do get a souvenir of the show. And the souvenir that you get is a genuine City of Toronto parking ticket.
Wow!
And you just have to pay it by the end of the week because you agreed to it. Or you could tell us what your word is out loud for all of us. Is that the word? And what is it?
Flower.
Flower is the word that you thought about. Okay, I hate fine print myself. So I like to print something in very big print, right on the back. Thank you so much. Thank you all so much. Thank you for coming to the best place for magic on the planet, the Chicago Magic Lounge. Such a pleasure to meet all of you. Thank you. Big round of applause for TJ, Ryan in the booth, all of your servers and staff, the management for having me here. Thank you, thank you, thank you. I'm Mark Clearview on Instagram, and I'll see you all later. Big round of applause for Jan Rose as she comes back. I've been Mark Clearview my whole life. Thank you.
Mark Clearview!
Thank you so much.
Mark!